name is Gloria Talamantes, go by Gloe. I do a lot of community work in and around the South and West Sides. Currently, what I'm working on are public murals. This year, I was able to get a little bit more intimate with my studio practice, learning new skills, having some time to myself to explore the possibilities of art making. I've been working on my project here, really looking into different like angles and perspectives of the car culture of Chicago. Taking photos of old classic cars, lowriders, custom cars. There's something really interesting about that process for me. Even though it's public, it's also very personal. What I've been doing is just interviewing people here and there. You know, art is all around the making of these custom cars. And then also like family legacy stories, which I think is the most fulfilling to hear how, you know, some of these skills, mechanic skills or learning how to change rims out. A lot of the folks who are in this culture have learned these passed down skills from their father, from uncles, from all kinds of different family. One of the things that is more organic for me with cars is the nostalgia behind being at home with my dad, being in his garage while he was working on his cars. He was always doing like the most like fun stuff. Seeing these cars getting pulled over left and right all over my neighborhood, it was like an unspoken thing where I'm like, I know they're only stopping them because their car looks like that. I started looking at quiet zone ordinances and policies that passed in the early and mid 90s. Similar to like my art practice where I can't purchase spray paint in the city, I started looking at things that affected car culture. For me, it's more like highlighting that resilience and the resistance that we've displayed over and over again. Because of the residency, I've been able to explore things that I've wanted to explore for a long time. And also look at information differently. The fact that, you know, you have access to archives here and all kinds of different resources has been really nice to lean on for support when it comes to, you know, working on my own. I think of public art more as a performance most times because there's always somebody watching while you're painting. You know, being in the studio is a little different. You get to see whatever I decide to share, right? I'm learning how to weave. I've been working with fabric a lot, which is something that I've always wanted to do. And I finally like got to explore that. I'm just like really excited because now I have these new sets of skills that I can amplify in any project. So I have pieces that I was able to dye with natural like plants and natural pigments. Each fabric was treated differently, like one was treated with copper, one was treated with iron, and I'm embroidering some of them with car lyric messages. When people see my work, I'd like for them to have a sense of joy. The joy of the process, the joy of the colors. I think growing up here has really guided that process for me, where if we don't have the resource, we create it. If there's not a way to put paint on the wall, we'll find a way. Even in the late 90s, when I started painting more publicly, you know, there's this graffiti blaster program. And so that in itself was an act of resistance, is to continue painting, even though there was this constant erasure. Millions and millions of dollars spent by the city to erase voices like mine. And so being able to share my story and kind of be the proof, right, of, hey, it might be difficult to do something, but it can be done if you don't give up.